Good evening and welcome to the Village of Romeoville's workshop meeting this Wednesday, May 1st, 2024. It's 6:01 PM. Can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Palmeyer.
Here.
Trustee Chavez. Trustee Clancy.
Here.
Trustee Richards.
Here.
Trustee Griffin.
Here.
Trustee Gary.
Here.
Mayor Noak.
Here.
We have a quorum.
Good. Maddie, will you lead us in the pledge?
To the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
And with that, our first item that we're going to have on the, we've got a couple of presentations up at the beginning tonight, and our first one's going to be 243297, which is a presentation honoring Gold Award Girl Scouts. And I'm going to come down right now. So I was just telling this very, very talented young person that we've had quite a few of them this year to recognize, but it's nice to have more people joining up here and that the community can celebrate. And Maddie is one of them. She received this Gold Award from Girl Scouts, and we want to come on up and we want to present that with her. You, and I mean, you mind talking and telling me about your project? Okay, I'm going to let you talk about it. Here, wait, come on up. Bring your microphone. Tell them about your project.
Hi, my name is Maddie Saranik. I'm a senior at Plainfield East High School, but I live in Romeoville. And my Gold Award Girl Scout project, it was a club I started at Plainfield East High School. It's called Club WE, which stands for Women's Empowerment. I am a two-sport female athlete. And I noticed that at my school, we were not being recognized the same way the men's sports were. And actually last year we won conference and it was not nearly as talked about as football, who didn't have as good of a season as ours, I guess. And so I started this club as a way to like promote awareness for different female events around the school, whether that be sports, in the arts. And it was just a very exciting opportunity. I got a few girls that I knew around the school that were as passionate as I was, and we were able to start this club. We've doubled our leadership since I started it last year, and it's just been a very exciting opportunity to get to lead other girls in the school and create more leaders. So, thank you.
Congratulations. Well, congratulations. And in recognition, I am going to write your school a check for $250 to your club to help out and keep it going. All right? Let's give Maddie an amazing round because it's just great. We've had so many good stories, and this is just yet another one. You are, should be very proud. I know you are, and I know your family is as well. And we are very excited for you as a community. So congratulations. Very good. To give her another round of applause, please, people. All right. Now, we have a... You're going to come up and present the presenter?
Yeah, sure.
You're totally throwing me off. next, we have our consultant for our grocery update. If you guys do need to go, you're more than welcome to. You can stay and hear the grocery update if you'd like. Mike puts on a good show. So our grocery study upstate. And Josh, you want to talk a little first?
Yes. This is a little bit of a different perspective.
Can I get that on?
Yeah.
Okay. All right, there we go.
Thank you, Mayor, members of the board, and good evening. We'd like to take this opportunity to introduce to you Mike Mallon. We engaged Mike Mallon early in 2022 to prepare a grocer market analysis and a grocer attraction strategy, focusing both on Weber Road and Route 53. Mike is a leading real estate expert in the grocer industry. He has over 40 years of experience in commercial real estate. He was a real estate executive for both American Stores, Jewel Esco, and Safeway Dominick's. Mike has developed over 190 grocery store projects and is currently involved in several projects in the Midwest. Mike is currently the managing partner of Malin & Associates. And with that, Mike is going to present a brief summary on his efforts.
Very good.
Appreciate that.
Wow, I'm not sure how I follow that. So, and I don't mean Josh, but I'm talking about that. Congratulations to you. I was very active in the Boy Scout program. It sounds like you're very active in the Girl Scout program and also involved in your school. So it's always kind of fun to be able to see the future leaders of our community. So congratulations, Betty. Good evening, Mayor and Village Trustees. I appreciate the opportunity this evening to share with you my findings regarding bringing additional grocery stores to the Village of Romeoville. As Josh mentioned, I was hired back in 2022. As we talked about prior to the meeting, I can't believe that it's been over 2 years. Time definitely flies. The whole purpose of the study was to go ahead and do a grocery feasibility study as well as an implementation plan. Over the last 2 years, I've worked very closely with the mayor, your staff, and we've identified two market areas to investigate to determine if the market would support additional grocery stores. The analysis focused on the grocery market potential for the Weber Road corridor as well as the Route 53 corridor. The research that we did included foot and vehicle traffic analytics, customer characteristics, research demographics, and geographic data. We identified several sites within the market, both in terms of existing stores, existing boxes, as well as we also looked at ground-up construction. We surveyed all of the existing grocery stores, both within the community, but also outside of the community that would be affected by the overall trade area. Utilizing a gravity model, which was used to determine what the market was in terms of sales potential, we did go ahead and we clarified that both Weber Road as well as Route 53 could support additional grocery stores. We then went ahead and took our findings and we identified over 38 grocery stores that we thought would be a good fit for the community and that also weren't currently servicing the area. Over the last year and a half, we have worked closely with several of those grocers, as well as property owners, developers, as well as your staff in order to be able to bring a grocery store to the village. We negotiated letters of intent. We also worked through potential village incentives to aggressively try to bring a grocery store to the village. After an extensive process, I'm disappointed that our efforts were unsuccessful. Grocers were concerned about competition, cannibalization, which means that they might have a sister store within or around the trade area, also market conditions as well as timings. We exhausted the options at this time. However, I believe, given the current changes in the grocery sector and the continuing growth of residential within the village, that we should revisit the market in the next 18 to 24 months. I have prepared extensive reports and studies that the staff has, but that really concludes my comments, and I'm happy to answer any questions that you or anyone might have as it relates to grocery, both in the community as well as outside. So thank you so much.
Oh, and thank you. Mike's knowledge in history with the industry is, you know, up there is one of the leading experts that you could find in this, and it's been a great partner with us on this. As you indicated, there were, you know, 38 or so stores that, you know, in the market that we identified. For the folks at home too, so they understand, there's probably many times more than that that are eliminated simply because they understanding that they don't have logistics capabilities in the area, they're not active in the market, a number of different reasons why they're eliminated almost immediately. So when you say the 38, those are 38 viable options.
Very, very much so.
That, you know, and there's many more that just simply were not viable that could be eliminated immediately. So that list is really much more comprehensive than even that. And as you said, both markets were explored. You know, for the folks at home too, you know, you also looked at, you know, what is capacity? So, you know, there is a limit to the size of the capacity that the market might support within the 53 corridor in terms of size and scope and sales, and also with the Weber Road corridor. To that end, you know, a large scale store would not be supported on 53, so that they understand that. However, a smaller scale store might be. Where on Weber Road, you could get a potentially larger store, but still within certain limits and expectations. Anything else you want to add to that?
Just a couple of things. Thank you, Mike. And as you said, Mayor, Mike has tremendous experience, and we appreciate all his time on this. One thing that Mike talked to a little bit, I mean, we were very aggressive. We were very, very aggressive with our incentives. We were very aggressive to competition. We tried to work with existing stores to see if there was opportunities there. And we're currently working with our other developments that still, like the Old Dominick's, the Romeoville Town Center, to see what is still a preferred use. If a grocery store is not going to work there, what is another preferred use that the community can benefit from? So we'll continue to work with them to bring them in there. And, you know, we have some developments already that, you know, the mayor will talk about the next couple weeks that are finalizing. But we're hoping to still leave some space available. So if there is a grocery store, but if there's another preferred use that comes down the road and it's something that'll benefit the community, I think there's great opportunity for that as well.
Yeah. And as you indicated, there's some hesitation about it, the current market status. Part of the problem, too, is that there's currently a very rapid evolution of the grocery industry. And while the folks, you know this, but the folks at home may not, even though they may see some of the articles here and there every day, whether it's through consolidation, it's through, in fact, some of that, even some of that consolidation and mergers is still having to go through federal processes. There's other ones that are being just recently announced that were being acquired. That creates a lot of uncertainty in the marketplace beyond simply, you know, what the market purchasing capacity might be. And so that's created another level of uncertainty, which I think is indicative of what you were saying in regards to right now, there's, you know, maybe not the opportunity, but that's not to say that opportunity might not exist in 18 to 24 months down the line as some of this plays out. And that's why we thought it was, you know, imperative to bring you up tonight. Just give everybody an update. You know, we've been working with you. We announced that we were working with you quite some time. But oftentimes people don't catch all that. And it's important to give them an update and the realities of what it takes to develop stores. Even, you know, people will often ask on the Dominick site, even that old former Dominick's at this point in time takes a lot of renovation, a significant investment far beyond probably what they realize in order to make that viable for any operation, whether it's grocer or any retailer at this point. And so there's a lot of hurdles that we overcome with that, in addition to the market uncertainties that exist at this time. But you know, it's a lot of work, a lot of discussions that have occurred, you know, and anything from the board? Any other questions, comments? Trustee Palmer, please.
Well, I'm not surprised at all by your findings. Of course, we're all disappointed by it. But brick and mortar in general is not doing well. And until that changes, I don't see a lot of opportunities.
Yeah, I think it is what we've, you know, Mike's heard and what we've heard is that I think they want to see some additional, some of the things that are dynamics are going on in the grocery industry as a whole that play out a little bit first, but also some things to help with the uncertainty in the market, both market corridors, you know, and things like, you know, more increased residential potentially, you know, increasing the market share that's available, additional development coming along, some other backfill, which we are already seeing, but it's still in the early process of that. They're probably going to be on the tail end of it, it sounds like,
right,
rather than on the front end of it. And so as this as we continue to see, which we, the village already is seeing, a lot of backfill and new interest. You know, like the LaRosse deal that was recently announced not too long ago with some new ownership there, new ownership actually in the Dominic Center, and I think they're going to have some leasing activity that they'll announce in the next few weeks. As that backfill comes in and some new other developments come in, and we hopefully see some positive population growth, those things will help, you know, bring us back to a point where we can have another conversation in 18 to 24 months. Anything else, Mr. Potter, you'd like to add? No? Okay. I got it covered. Thanks. We spent quite a bit of time. You know, unfortunately, there's a lot of proprietary information with these grocers. There's a lot of things that we cannot disclose as you're seeking these deals. That's why we have Mike to work with us and had him to work with us. So, you know, we can't talk about every deal because it's always, you know, they're always in process and there's always elements that have to be, you know, that those companies don't, you know, aren't comfortable with going out and saying yes or no yet. While this window may not, if you know, be the window at the moment, I think the more positive thing is that this isn't done. We're not stopping. This is just an update, and that you know, there are future windows, and we keep pursuing and trying to work on the things that will hopefully make the market a more desirable market. Trustee Richards, please.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. One of the things you just brought up, I just want to kind of add to that. So the reason I like this update, and I appreciate all the time and effort you put into it. A lot of comprehensive work. You know, we all keep in touch with staff here. So, you know, we've been aware of what's going on all along. But I think it's a good update for the public to see that it takes a lot more than people probably realize for a store to come here, regardless of the type of retailer it is, whether it's grocer, whether it's, you know, whatever retail you're talking about. We can't make them come. And we ask and we talk to people and we send consultants out to do this work. Ultimately, they've got to want to be here at this point in time. And so I think it's a great way for them to hear from someone just how much time and effort has gone into some of this. So I really do appreciate everything you've done.
I'm going to steal your quote. We've never told the grocery store no.
I use that one regularly. I've never told anyone they couldn't come.
If I could add to that, Trustee Richards. You know, it's one of those things, even though I may be done with my contract, I guarantee you that hopefully this is not the last time you see me. It's one of those things that I eat, drink, and sleep grocery stores. And so I'm out there constantly talking with them. And the one thing that this process has done, and I have to compliment your staff as well as your mayor, because they've been with me, you know, hand in hand throughout the entire process. And again, very, very aggressive. And it's been unbelievable. I'm going to go ahead and continue to keep Romeoville on their mind and also about the opportunities. So really, until I can be there for the ribbon cutting along with the mayor, my job is not done.
Yeah, and it has been a pleasure to work with Mike. You know, we've really turned over every rock possible. I would dare to say that we have, and Mike can tell you what his thoughts are on it, we've probably offered some of the most aggressive offers for a grocery store in the state's history. So, you know, amongst those, I mean, you'd be hard pressed. And sometimes it's just, you've got to work with the market factors and timing that you have.
Timing is so, so crucial on real estate transaction.
And what we can do is keep our eye on the target, keep working on it, and hopefully, you know, you'll see what the opportunities present, and, you know, hopefully in the next 18, 24 months, in the next realistic window, probably, and it's always not to say, we're always going to keep working on it. Mr. Potter knows that he's never going to stop working on, and we are never going to stop working on a grocery store. But it was imperative that we give everybody an update just so they understand some of the things involved in it. So, anything else anybody wanted to add? Nope. Very
good. All right. Thank you very much. Appreciate it.
Very good. Next we have Ordinance 24-1914, an ordinance adopting amendments to Chapter 42A, Administrative Adjudication, and Chapter 151 of the Village Code of Ordinances. Mr. Vogel, please.
Thank you, Your Honor. What we have here tonight is just to accomplish a little bit of internal administrative and enforcement reorganization. Commercial code enforcement has for, you know, the recent however many years been handled through the Community Development Department. But after some internal thinking about our process and how we can do things differently, the direction now being proposed with this ordinance is to transfer the commercial code enforcement responsibilities from Community Development to the Fire Prevention Bureau. A lot of the codes that both of those folks would enforce, you know, there's some commonality, there's some crossover, and so it just was thought that this would be a good opportunity to get the Fire Prevention Bureau involved in commercial code enforcement, both from the strict fire and life safety codes, some of the building and property maintenance codes, and they're also going to handle zoning enforcement. So we've provided for a fine schedule, and this is what we need in order to accomplish that transition.
Very good. Any questions or comments?
No.
Give it a try. Next, resolution 243788, a resolution approving an amendment to the professional service agreement proposal from Hitchcock Design Group for Romeo Crossing Phase 3. And Kelly. Oh,
thank you, Mayor. Okay. Thank you, Mayor. Tonight, we are asking for approval to amend the professional service agreements with Hitchcock Design for Romeo Crossing Phase 3. Romeo Crossing Phase 3 is a continuation of the master plan commitment to develop the 60 acres along 135th Street. We are currently in the final stages of Phase 1 and 2. Romeo Crossing Phase 3 will focus on the installation of the adaptive sports field, inclusive playground, fitness challenge course, pedestrian circulation connection, playground, fitness course, sorry, I said that already, future connections from previous phases, music play area, restroom building, shelter, bago set, site furnishing, interpretive signage, butterfly garden, and sport lighting to the adaptive sport field. The addendum to this agreement includes adding design and documentation for the area of the full parking lot as identified in the master plan, including civil, electrical, and landscape architectural related services. The approval for the professional service agreement amendment from Hitchcock Design Group, all items will be amended, are in the design of the parcel, parking lot completion, electrical engineering for the parking lot, conduit, wiring, layout, material plans, containment curb, pedestrian walkway, improvement associated with the parking lot build-out, construction, civil engineering services, and landscaping. Once we have the construction cost, we'll come back to the mayor and board for final approval. I also want to mention part of this project was offset by the OSLID grant, the open space land acquisition. There is a conceptual plan here for you to view if you have any questions.
Very good. It's coming along. It looks beautiful out there. It's amazing, the transformation.
For the board's update for phase 1 and 2, we are hoping to have that completed by June.
Yeah, for folks at home, if you didn't catch that, you're hoping to have, and that phase 1 includes the dog park areas, anything else that'll be open at that point?
Yes, absolutely. The dog park and 36 stalls will be ready.
That portion of the parking lot.
Correct.
Will the hill be done
at
that
hill,
point?
Yes, the hill will be done for this upcoming winter season, yes.
Well,
and the steps.
They can do the steps for fitness.
They can do the steps
summer.
For fitness.
Yeah. But that's good news. Go get your sleds ready. Yeah, start scoping them out. You know, if you got that extra special spray that makes it go fast from Christmas.
There also is the village manager wanted me to mention, too. Once completion of phase 3, we will receive $300,000 from Northern Will County SRA. And then for 10 years after that, we'll get $30,000 towards this project.
Very good. Good partnership. Any other questions?
It's just an amazing project, Kelly. I can't wait to see it completed, but just amazing what you guys are doing over there.
Yeah, that's great. It's going to come along really nice.
This park really changed that corridor. It just, absolute. You know, and for the folks at home, too, my engineers will nod probably on this. You know, the ability to also then deal with things like stormwater and other issues that occurred in the area. You know, farmland isn't necessarily designed to properly deal with modern stormwater standards. So this was a big evolution of this site. So, and something for the last few generations, mm-hmm. It really is. I mean, mm-hmm. this is a legacy project for the whole community to enjoy, and especially that part of the community. So Thank you.
Thank you.
And you have the next one, don't you?
I do.
Resolution 243789, a resolution authoring an agreement with Live Barn Inc.
It is. Thank you, Mayor. Tonight we are seeking approval to enter into agreement with Live Barn for the Athletic and Event Center. This proposed agreement will give Live Barn the exclusive right to produce live broadcast of events at the Athletic and Events Center. This is a six-year agreement, and the village will receive 30% of the subscription revenues less the $600 deduction for the internet service paid for by Live Barn. The village will also receive 5% of pay-per-view revenue for streaming tournaments conducted by third parties. We're excited to enter into this agreement with Live Barn, if approved.
Very good. Sounds like a great plan. Any questions or comments? It's amazing what kind of sports you can watch on different things these days. You can catch just about anything. Very good. Thank you.
Thank you.
Resolution 243784, a resolution to approve a task order from Strand Engineering for the planning and design services for the lake water supply modifications. Mr. Dre, and then I think you're going to turn it over, aren't you?
I'm going to do what Josh did there, and yes, turn this over to Chris Holm.
You guys do great introductions of people, I'm telling you.
So Chris has been up in front of us several times, and I think he'll continue as we're going with the Lake Michigan Water Project. We had a public meeting last night out at the firehouse number 3 to talk with the area residents regarding what we're proposing to do behind the Lukansik School. We had some good comments. We did have some concerns that we will address during, you know, our design and through that process. And Chris was available last night to join us, so he had heard that. But I just wanted to simply start and have him walk through what the scope of work is planned.
But you had the, as you indicated, you had that public meeting last night. It went well.
Yeah. It went well, very well, yes.
Yeah. Excellent. Thank you all for having me here tonight for this episode of the Chris and Chris Show. I'm excited to be here because this is the first and the biggest step for the village in putting in some infrastructure for receiving Lake Michigan water. So this project that we're looking at here is basically going to be two different contracts, one to construct the two storage tanks that are on the site, two 1.5 million gallon storage tanks, and the second one to construct the pumping station that then pumps water out. Now this, again, the people last night weren't as excited as I was about this, but maybe you guys will be. This is the first and freshest Grand Prairie Water Commission water. This is the first drop-off point, and I thought they would care about that, but they didn't seem to. So as I mentioned, it's two different contracts, and that's so the contractor can build the tanks first without the building contractor, two separate styles, and then they'll come in behind with the booster station. And then the commission will be in on a separate project at some point in time to put a meter station in. So this agreement here tonight before you is to, first of all, put together a project planning document in conjunction with a preliminary design document. The IEPA project planning document is to receive two loans, one for the booster store, or one for the storage tanks and one for the booster station. That document is good for 5 years if you get approval on that. We're hoping to be able to get the loan money on the 2026, in the year 2026, it would actually be F by 2027. But if not, as shown on this schedule here, it can slide a year and still be okay. But we want to start trying to get the money now. It's not always a guarantee that you're going to be receive the money the first time you go after it. So possibly 26 start, likely 2027 start with the tanks and then the booster station coming in, either 27 or 28 behind that.
Very good. And for the folks at home, these are not high elevated tanks. Actually, we're sinking these in. They're similar, if anybody's ever seen them, to the one we have on Airport Road, right across from Boucher Prairie Park.
Correct.
Similar in style to that.
Similar in style. That one's actually 3 million gallons. These will be 1.5 million gallons, mm-hmm. So it'll be similar in style, but two smaller tanks.
Very good. So it'll be behind the area where the schools is. It'll be off from the houses. Unless you're way back in there, you probably will never see these. But this is with topography and engineering, this is the best location that is available.
Yeah, and thank you. I wanted to mention that too, that the reason that this location and this station, the reason that this location is so good for the station is this station can then actually serve the entire village. Now, there is a second delivery point that would always be there, but if for some reason that was down or needed to be taken down for maintenance, this booster station does have the capability of supplying the entire village because of this location that it's being placed into.
Yeah, okay, in case anybody was wondering why. Very good. Any questions, comments?
No.
Mayor?
Yeah.
There was one other thing, you know, when we talked about the tanks, Don had mentioned a great point. The tank out at Airport Road is relatively the same height as a two-story home. So that's the goal that we're going to try to shoot for and try to make sure that we have, you know, as low profile as we can do on that site within reason of the cost and all that for that, you know, the layout of the project.
Yeah, the goal is to have some of the tank underground and limit the amount of height that's coming up. So, and again, coloration also as well. Try and keep, you know, color schemes that kind of fade into the background. So it'll be heavily landscaped. So very good. Any other questions, comments? Excellent. It's nice to see things going.
Yep. Here we go.
This is, as you said, this will be the first place that you could actually draw the water really for, you know, public use on the system coming out from the pipeline from Chicago.
The freshest.
Freshest.
Thank you.
You have the funnest lines.
Thanks, Chris.
We won't tell Minooka that on the tail end of the system. Keep that to ourselves. Shannon, yeah. Very good. Next, we have the Chris Dre show tonight?
Yes, sir.
Next, we have Resolution 3780, a resolution waiving the bid process and enter into a professional service contract with Applied Research Associates to perform pavement condition surveys. Mr. Dre.
Thank you. This is a service that had been utilized in the past. Back in 2018, we had a truck similar to what's on the screen go through the community and monitor the pavement. And why do we do that? We do that because we want to make sure we identify a little bit more than just our eyes and judge what the road condition is. So what this truck will do is it'll monitor, it'll grab every crack, every piece, get depths and all of that. There's an availability for us to even get the ride of the road. So we wanted to go back to use ARA because they are very good at what they do. They're in the state of Illinois and they have our data. So one of the things that we're able to do is we're able to plot the road condition, which is this next slide, and help us get another point on our charts for our roads. What we try to do is keep our roads in that fair condition so that we don't get into a situation where we're dropping into poor or very poor, requiring more maintenance than necessary. So what we're hoping to get out of this service is, again, an updated rating of all of our roads in the community. One of the things I would point out on this chart, why we crack seal, it's so that we can try to keep this PCI, the rating, the value of the condition of the road, high as we can for as long as we can, because it's basically a curve. Once the road starts to degrade, it'll just get worse as it goes. One of good example of one of the roads that need reconstruction would be Greenwood. It's structurally in a good shape, but the top is definitely got some excessive wear, and we'll have to definitely reconstruct that road in the next year here. But We're excited to do this because, again, we want to make sure we have a reason to do these road repairs.
Yeah, very good. And it's good to remind, again, the residents at home that may be watching that, you know, the way the roads are selected isn't us going out there and just saying we think this needs. There is a method that's done this. There is a process. Your team works with this and they take other information, a lot of other data. And that's how that is determined. It is done very, very professionally, and we appreciate that. And it gets us the maximum lifespan we can out of, you know, if somebody at home can come up with some methodology of keeping roads from cracking in a cold and hot climate such as Illinois, there are billions of dollars to be made. So yes, if you have that great idea, please let us know. Don't copyright it. We want to. The contractors might not appreciate it, but until somebody figures it out, unfortunately, this is the reality we live in this climate.
Yes.
Questions or comments? Trustee Griffin, please.
So Chris, this rather strange-looking truck is going to be driving around all the roads in the village this summer?
That's correct, yes. Okay. I don't have a schedule yet of when they're due to be up in this area, but you know, upon your approval, we would get that schedule and we'd let everybody know.
Oh, good. Letting people know is a good idea.
Yeah. So they don't think the NSA is
yeah,
out there.
Strange, yeah,
people waving that they think it's the Google car.
They might think it's just a Google truck, though, you know, anymore. Yeah, that's good. Anything else? Any other questions or comments? Anything else to contribute to that? Great job.
Thank you.
As always. We'll move on to your next one. Resolution 243785. Resolution to waive the bid process, accept the lowest proposal, and enter into contract for the 2024 hot mix asphalt program. Just kind of rolled right into that, didn't you?
This is why we're doing, yes, this is why we're doing what we're doing. We're going to work with Orange Crush. This is going to be for our internal, I made some notes here, sorry. This will be for our project that the village staff does, and I'll get to that on the last slide, on all of the other resolutions, but because this map is kind of hard to see. This has all of our programs for this year, and what we're looking at is we'll be out in Westlake in the blue area in the bottom couple spots, and again, I'll talk about that more in the last slide. The green area is what we focus on in town, and let me go to that. So it'll be Princeton, Arnold, Gavin, Roof, Dexter, Delta, Cascade, a bit of Naperville Road. We'll be taken care of. So this is the hot mix we need to run our asphalt crew.
Very good. Questions or comments? Again, if anybody's ever got questions, please feel free to call Chris and his department. They will be happy to discuss it. If there's ever any issues with any of the contracting work going on, please just reach out. They're happy to assist. If there's no other comments about that, we'll go right into the companion one of that, I would assume. Resolution 243786, a resolution to approve the extension of the concrete repair program with Builders Concrete.
Thank you, Mayor. The concrete, we utilize this contract for all the repairs that we do, from water main breaks, any types of other repairs that we see throughout. The work that we do on the roads that the village will maintain or repair, resurface this year, we need a concrete company to help us with that work. So that's part of this. And then also in this contract with Orange Crush is our ADA program. We are moving our ADA program. We are planning to do some work around Sub 5, north of Normantown Road, but we have a water main project that's going to be out to bid soon.
You realize that terminology is only used by your department, right?
I'm sorry. So it would be north of Normantown Road, Hudson, Farragut, those streets. We're going to have a water main project coming. Yes, Trustee, it's going to be your neighborhood. So we moved our ADA program out to the other side of town. This is the map. This is the area that we'll focus on. Our goal with our ADA program is, though we may have been in a subdivision recently to address the road or something else, as you mentioned earlier, concrete moves, and that's all because of our thaw and freeze cycles. So this is the area we'll be in, along with multiple lists of areas we need to repair.
Very good. I will say that let's stay on top of our concrete contractors.
There has been
some concerns in the
urgent
past.
Number one conversation
and
with staff.
We want to make sure we are addressing any of the concerns our residents have on any of the work being done and try and make it as tidy as possible. I'm just going to ask this again. When we're doing apron work, if we can figure out a way to at least offer a partnership with the homeowner that they can have their complete apron done if they cover the remaining the balance of it. Can we investigate that possibility?
Yes, sir.
If they want to not have just one, have it cut, but have the entire thing, understanding that, you know, the additional would be at some shared kind of pricing. But let's look and see if we can at least offer an option.
Okay.
So I think people would appreciate that.
Sounds good.
Very good. Any other questions or comments? Mm-hmm. Excellent. Very good. Next, you have Resolution 243787, a resolution to waive the bid process and accept the lowest proposal and enter into contract for the 2024 subdivision resurfacing project. You're just exciting.
I'm excited. It's May 1st. We have a new budget.
People love to hear about working our roads.
Yeah. And I don't remember how many capital projects. There's just a lot. So we'll be in front of you for a little bit here in the next couple of weeks meetings. This is for our in-house resurfacing. I'm going to move to this next slide. We are bouncing around a little bit. We're going to do some more work out at Westlake and try to get that accomplished and finished up. It was a lot of area, and then we also had a need that we needed to go and do a different area. So what's in front of you, the blue is our collector resurfacing. That's what PT Farrow gave us the lowest price on, which is in the packet for your for potential approval from you all. We also have some resurfacing. Windham Lakes and some of our business parks, to do the whole subdivision is just very expensive in those business parks. So what we've tried to do is worked with village administrator and staff on how we can get in there and make a good impact. So we'll be out in Windham Lakes doing Lakeview Court, Arbor Drive, and then, as it says, we'll be going and doing some work on Greenwood. And then we've got the resurfacing, as we all know, for Will County on 135th from 53 to Weber. What we've talked about tonight, though, is in the blue and the green.
Very good. Any questions or comments? Excellent. Thank you. That was pretty extensive tonight.
Thank you.
Very good job, as always. If no other comments, I'll entertain a motion to adjourn.
So moved. Second.
Motion by Trustee Clancy, second by Trustee Griffin. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
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 Nays, the ayes have it. We have the first meeting adjourned. We'll go right into the regular meeting of the Village of Romeoville this May 1st, 2024 at 6:44 p.m. Can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Palmeyer.
Here.
Trustee Chavez. Trustee Clancy.
Here.
Trustee Richards.
Here.
Trustee Griffin.
Here.
Trustee Aguirre.
Here.
Mayor Noak.
Here.
We have a quorum.
Very good. Trustee Geary, will you lead us in the pledge?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. We don't have any petitions from the public this evening. A motion for consent agenda by
second.
Trustee Griffin, second by Trustee Palmeyer. Any further discussion? Hearing none, can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Griffin?
Aye.
Trustee Palmeyer?
Aye.
Trustee Clancy?
Aye.
Trustee Richards?
Aye.
And Trustee Aguirre?
Aye.
Motion carried.
Very good. Within that consent agenda, then, we have minutes 240975, approval of minutes workshop meeting April 17th, 2024. Minutes 240976, approval of minutes regular meeting April 17th, 2024. 243290, approval of bill schedule A. 243291, approval of bill schedule B. 243292, approval of bill schedule C. Ordinance 241912, an ordinance amending Chapter 35 of the Village Code of Ordinances, Boards and Commissions, Boards of Police and Fire Commissioners. Resolution 243774, a resolution establishing a development security for the public stormwater erosion control improvements at the redevelopment of 1320 Enterprise Drive. Resolution 243775, resolution accepting the public improvements of 1203 Lakeview Drive. Resolution 243776, resolution waiving the bidding requirements and accepting the proposal from CIT Trucks for the purchase of 2025 T480 Kenilworth single axle dump truck chassis. Resolution 243777, a resolution waiving the bid requirements and accepting the proposal from Monroe Truck Equipment for the purchase of an upfitter dump body and new snow and ice control equipment to be installed on the 2024 Kenilworth chassis. Resolution 243778, resolution waiving the bid requirements and accepting the proposal from Rod Baker Ford for the purchase of 5 Ford Interceptor Police Squad vehicles. Resolution 243779, a resolution waiving the bid and approving an agreement with Core and Main as the sole supplier of Census water meters. Resolution 243781, a resolution to waive the bid process and enter into professional services contracts with Gonzalez Companies for LLC for bridge inspections. Resolution 243782, resolution to waive the bid process and enter into a contract with PT Farrow Construction Company for the bridge maintenance work. Resolution 243783, resolution for the use of MFT funds for to maintain streets of the village of Romeoville for fiscal year 2024. To a motion.
So moved.
Motion to approve by Trustee Giffen.
Second.
Second by Trustee Richards. Any further discussion? Hearing none, can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Griffin.
Aye.
Trustee Richards.
Aye.
Trustee Pallmeyer.
Aye.
Trustee Clancy.
Aye.
Trustee Gary.
Aye.
Motion carried.
Very good. Thank you. All right. We've got a few proclamations here. We're going to start off with 243296. A lot. 243296, a proclamation declaring May 2024 as Water Safety Month in the village of Romeoville.
So moved. Motion.
Motion by Trustee Griffin.
Second.
Second by Trustee Richards. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Nays, the ayes have it. I'm going to come down because I have a presentation for this one. This is a new one for us this time. National Water Safety Month, May 2024, whereas swimming and aquatic related activities have positive impacts on physical and mental health and can enhance one's quality of life, and whereas education regarding the topic of water safety plays an essential role in preventing drownings and recreational water related injuries, and whereas contributions made by the recreation water industry as represented by the organizations involved in the National Water Safety Month Coalition have led to the development of safe swim facilities, aquatic programs, home pools, spas, and related activities that provide healthy places to recreate, learn, and grow, and build our self-esteem, confidence, and sense of self-worth, which contributes to the quality of life of our communities. And whereas we commend the ongoing efforts and commitments to educate the public on pool safety issues and initiatives by the pool, water park, recreation, and park industries. And whereas the Romeoville Recreation Department is proud to offer water safety programs such as swimming lessons for a variety of ages and Water Safety Wednesday at the Aquatic Center on May 22nd, where participants will engage in hands-on activities to learn more about being safe in and around water. And whereas the communication of water safety rules and programs to families and individuals of all ages is vital for owners of private pools, users of public swimming facilities, and visitors to water parks. Now, therefore, I, John D. Noak, the mayor of the Village of Romeoville, hereby proclaim May 2024 as Water Safety Month in the Village of Romeoville and encourage our residents to take precautions when enjoying local aquatic center and splash pads available. You want to say anything?
Sure.
Now, you might have noticed we have this new aquatic center and we got some really amazing staff that brought this to our attention and do a great job. And you want to say a few things? Go ahead.
Sure. Well, thank you, Mayor. Thank you to everybody here tonight. My name is Lauren Ryan. I'm the aquatics manager at the Romeoville Aquatic Center. I'm really happy that we're participating in Water Safety Month in May. It's a nationally recognized effort. There's a lot of programs, activities, events that we are initiating at the Romeoville Aquatic Center, including swim lessons, our river walking, aquatic fitness, including an event at the end of this month on the 22nd, a Water Safety Wednesday, where the members of the Romeoville community are welcome to come out, enjoy the Romeoville Aquatic Center, learn a lot more about water safety, various topics, some ranging for younger swimmers of preschool and young elementary school age, all the way through parents and adults that perhaps want to learn a little bit more about keeping their families and their facilities and their home pools a safe place for them to enjoy the aquatic activities. So, thank you.
Thank you.
Just while you're heading back up there, Mayor, just want to again thank Kelly, Lauren, and Marissa for all the work that they did to get the Aquatic Center up and running. They had a lot of challenges to overcome, whether it was to get enough lifeguards to be there, and this is actually going to be our first full summer with the splash pad that will be open on when, Kelly? Memorial Day weekend, so this will be our first full summer with that. So they've done a great job getting everything together over there.
Every time I bring, so oftentimes when I'm doing my ride around towns, and I'll bring a group over to the, it will stop at the Aquatic Center. They are always blown away. They can't help believe how nice it is. And it's a lot of credit to everybody involved at Parks and Rec that have been a part of that project and continue to be a part of it and running just an outstanding facility. And we should all be very proud of what they've done. And could thank them for everything they continue to do. So thank you. Very good. Next we have 24-32-93, a proclamation declaring May 2024 as Asian American and Pacific Islander Heritage Month in the Village of Romeoville.
So moved.
Motion by Trustee Griffin, second by Trustee Pallmeyer. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Nay, the ayes have it. Asian American and Pacific Islander Heritage Month, May 2024. Whereas Asian American Pacific Islander Heritage Month is observed during the month of May to recognize the contributions and influence of Asian Americans and Pacific Islander Americans to the history, culture, and achievements of the United States. And whereas for more than a century, Asian American and Pacific Islander men and women have made valuable contributions to all areas of life in Illinois, including government, business, arts, sciences, medicine, education, law enforcement, and military. And whereas Asian American and Pacific Islander communities are deeply rooted in both the United States and Illinois, reminding us of both proud and painful chapters of our history. And whereas Asian American and Pacific Islander communities have shared their rich culture and traditions while representing their communities through public service and advocacy. And whereas diversity represents one of our greatest strengths, and by recognizing the contributions and accomplishments of Asian American and Pacific Islander men and women, our community celebrates the importance of inclusion to building a brighter future for all of our citizens. And whereas the Village of Romeoville is committed to providing comprehensive support to ensure our community is equitable and welcoming to all people. And whereas the Village of Romeoville is proud to celebrate Asian American and Pacific Islander Heritage Month and commemorate the essential contributions, sacrifices, and accomplishments that Asian American and Pacific Islanders have made. Now, therefore, I, John D. Noak, the Mayor of the Village of Romeoville, do hereby proclaim the month of May 2024 as Asian American and Pacific Islander Heritage Month and encourage our staff and community to observe, recognize, and celebrate the culture, heritage, and contributions of Asian American and Pacific Islanders to our community, our state, and our cities, and our schools. Very good. Next we have, I said there's a list tonight, 24-32-94, a proclamation declaring May 2024 as Jewish American Heritage Month in the Village of Roanoke.
So moved.
Motion by Trustee Griffin.
Second.
Second by Trustee Richards. Any further discussion? Hearing none, can I, all those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Nays, the ayes have it. Jewish American Heritage Month, May 2024. Whereas Jewish immigrants to America ever since their first arrival to our shores in the 16th century have played a central role in the creation, growth, freedom, prosperity, and strength of the United States of America. And whereas Jewish citizens have played a central role in Illinois, including serving in the armed forces of the United States National Guard. And whereas the State of Israel is now celebrating over 75 years of its modern founding and its emergence over the last few decades as a beacon of freedom, prosperity, and world leader in technology, agriculture, water conservation, medicine, and all manner of innovation. And whereas for years, every president of the United States has declared a period of time for celebrating the contributions of the United States of the Jewish community's history in the United States, to the history, heritage, and culture. And since 2006, the month of May has been presidentially declared to be Jewish American Heritage Month pursuant to a bipartisan resolution of Congress. And now, therefore, I, John Dean Oak, the mayor of the village of Romeoville, here declare and proclaim May 2024 to be Jewish American Heritage Month in the village of Romeoville, and call upon all citizens, schools, colleges, and universities to commemorate this occasion by appropriate celebrating contributions to our country and Illinois of the Jewish community's history, heritage, and culture. Good. We're not done. We got more. 243295, proclamation declaring 2024 as Mental Health Awareness Month in the village of Romeoville.
So moved.
Second by Trustee Griffin.
I know. I need some water.
Second by Trustee Clancy. Any further discussion? Hearing none, all those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Nays? The ayes have it. Mental Health Awareness Month, May 2024, whereas mental health is essential to everyone's overall health and well-being, and whereas all Americans experience times of difficulty and stress in their lives, and whereas prevention is an effective way to reduce the burden of mental health conditions, and whereas there is a strong body of research that supports specific tools that all Americans can use to better handle challenges and protect their health and well-being, and whereas mental health conditions are real and prevalent in our nation, and whereas with early and effective treatment, those individuals with mental health conditions can recover and lead full productive lives, and whereas each business, school, government agency, healthcare provider, organization, and citizen share the same burden of mental health problems and has a responsibility to promote mental health wellness and support prevention efforts. Now, therefore, I, John Dean Oak, the mayor of the village of Romeoville, do hereby proclaim May 2024 as Mental Health Month and in the village of Romeoville, and call upon its citizens, government agencies, public and private institutions, business and schools in Romeoville to recommit to our community increasing the awareness and understanding of mental health and the steps our citizens can take to protect their mental health and the need in appropriate and accessible services for all people with mental health conditions. Thanks. Whew, that was a lot. And for folks at home, you know, proclamations of these nature are usually based on federal and state existing ones. Thank you to the Rec Department for bringing this, because it's great that we highlight the aquatic with our new aquatic center. It's very fitting, so thank you for that addition. I think that's the most we've ever done in one particular. May is a particularly busy one month, so we'll have quite a few on the next one as well. So. But if anybody ever wondered, these come from national and state recognitions that are already established. So, I got more of my report. That was a lot of talking, though. First, I want to once again congratulate Maddie. We do have another one. I don't think she was able to attend, but we will get her, if she can, maybe in the future. But if not, we'll get her certificate as well. We've outstanding young people in our community doing some just absolutely amazing things. We've seen it a lot already this year. Also, I want to thank the White Oak Library. They had a focus group on kind of some strategic planning I was able to take part in. I know our village manager was able to take part in one of their sessions as well. Always appreciate our partnerships with the library system. And for those who, again, don't know, we are the headquarters for the White Oak Library, so something that we're very proud of. And one of our businesses that's a big part of our community, Geodis, had a ribbon cutting. They're onto their fifth facility now, and hundreds of employees in our community, and very active. You know, oftentimes people don't realize how active some of these companies really are, and Geodis has done an outstanding job. Very involved in chamber, things we're doing. A lot of their employees are involved in the community. Just a great group. We also had a ribbon cutting for the Ovation Center. Very exciting to finally get that open. They had a kind of a week-long grand opening. So if you're curious, you want to see what it looks like, you can pop your head in now. They're in there. So more offices will be opening and phasing in. But a lot of the facilities open and available for you to go through. So. And we planted a tree the second year in a row we've been at RC Hill. We have the contest winners for the Keep Rooming the Beautiful contest winners that we have every year and that the committee does. And the winner again was at RC Hill 2 years in a row. So we planted another tree over there. Last year we were in the front of the building. This year we were in the playground area. Those kids, I think, would have just actually planted the whole thing by themselves if we'd given them the chance. They put a lot of the dirt back on it. But just a great group. The two winners were excellent, very engaging. Their parents should be very proud of those young men. But the whole class, just an amazing group of kids. And they do such a great job, and we thank the partnership with Valley View School District. So, went over to the university, Lucy University. There's a playing pool over there with Special Olympics. And if you've never had the opportunity to be a part of this, we've been doing, how many years have we been over there now? You remember off the top of your head, Chief? Four, I think it is. Four or five. And it's every year we have some challenging weather. This year it was wind, less rain. It was more wind this year. At least the temperature was up a little bit. Sleeting and rain and cold weather doesn't do too well when you're trying to pull a big giant plane. And United Airlines brought in a plane for the plane pool. We had departments. We have various people out there helping. Lots of community groups. I know the high school had some groups out there. I saw State Representative Avalor was out there. So it was State Rep Harry Benton that was out there as well from Plainfield. People from all around, teams from everywhere. Law enforcement's really a big driver on this one, but everybody steps to the occasion to be part of it. And it's kind of neat to see people try and pull a plane and race it.
Did I see the Stay Puft Marshmallow?
Oh, yeah, there was the local Ghostbusters cosplayers were out there as well. I mean, it's turned into quite the event these days. And Lewis University is gracious enough to let us use their facility too. And I just can't say enough. And everybody involved from our police department just does an amazing job on this. So they really have a passion for it. And they should be very proud of what they accomplished.
Public Works also participated in that. If I'm not mistaken, I want to say that the high school actually was in first place. Romeoville High School, I think, ended up in first place. Was that?
For their category.
Yes.
Yeah. And Public Works.
That was going to be my next
police department.
There's always some competition going on out there. And this was the biggest crowd they ever had.
Yeah, they had over 40 yeah. teams, I believe.
Yeah.
They did a great job.
So, Romeoville High School, huh? Those football kids, huh? Yeah, they were. I know they were prepping. I mean, they were very serious this year. I saw some of their posts about it ahead of time. They were ready. They came prepared. So good for them. Excellent. It was nice being out there. Like I said, the only thing I wish the wind would have died down a little bit, but that was all right. That wasn't too bad. Very good. Excellent event. We also have Plainfield 202's Foundation coming up tomorrow. We've got. I'm going to be visiting over at Grand Haven with the representative or Leader Manley on Friday. We also have readers. I think who else is going to be reading? I think a few of us may be reading over at Hermanson soon as guest readers. A lot coming up, and believe it or not, summer will be around the corner as everybody from the rec department is nodding their heads because it's coming in a busy season. So I know the event calendars are out. And you're putting out all the information on various platforms and all the concerts and all the other events. Really, I can't say enough about what our Parks and Rec Department do throughout the entire season. It's the busiest part of the season, and they do an amazing job. So if you see one of them, let them know and thank them for all the wonderful work they do. And with that, I will turn it over to our clerk's report.
Thank you, Mayor Noak. The Valley View Educational Enrichment Foundation Board met on April 18th here at Village Hall. The items we discussed included the request for the March dinner, I'm sorry, the results of the March dinner and raffle. Approximately $39,000 in profit.
Nice.
Was made. The number of applications for scholarships, the teachers wrote, there were 72 requests. The board approved a total of $50,000 to $60,000 including the funds from the Valley View School District. We also talked about the annual golf outing on June 6th at Bolingbrook Golf Club. All the foursomes are sold out. There are some whole sponsors still needed. And the 2025 dinner and raffle is scheduled for Friday, March 7th. And we haven't picked the theme yet. I'll let you know as soon as that happens. And the next meeting will be really in conflict with the police department dinner. So I'm sure that Ken and I will not be attending it. So I'll have to get the minutes and let you know what was decided. And I would like to congratulate Maddie and the project that she started at the high school. And finally, I would like to wish all the current mothers and moms to be a very happy Mother's Day. Also, the grandmas. That's the end of my report. Okay.
Very good. Citizens Committee and Commissions and Liaison Reports. Trustee Geary, Fire and Police.
Thank you, Mayor. For Fire and Police, the final eligibility list for Firefighter Lieutenant is up. And their next meeting will be Tuesday, May 14th at 6:30 p.m. And for Conservation and Sustainability, the next meeting will be Wednesday, May the 8th at 6 p.m. And a quick reminder, on Saturday, May 18th from 9 to 2, and Sunday, May 19th, will be the native plant sale at Isle of Cachet. For the if you make a purchase, you'll get a free plug courtesy of the Village of Romeoville. And also there's going to be a pollinator party at the Isle of Cachet, and they will have another pop-up native plant sale, and that's going to be on June 15th from 10 to 2. And also just a quick reminder, the village has a sale on rain barrels. It's a great way to water your gardens with our rain, and the sale goes through May the 12th. So go on the village website and order one, and I think you pick it up, and it'll give you instructions how to pick it up. You'll go to Public Works to pick it up. So that'll be great. That's all I have, Mayor. Thank you.
Very good. Trustee Richards, Planning Zoning, Zoning Board of Appeals, REMA.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. No update on REMA, but I do have a brief one on Planning and Zoning Commission. Next meeting is scheduled for May 14th. And that on that agenda, we'll have two items. Edward Rose and Sons General Development Plan. That's for residential development on a North Ward farm property on Weber Road, Weber and 135th. And the Earth Mover Credit Union Concept for Weber and Airport.
Go ahead. Good. Trustee Clancy, Keep Romeoville Beautiful, Parks and Rec.
Thank you. Keep Romeoville Beautiful. Our next meeting will be tomorrow, May 2nd at 1 p.m. here at Village Hall. And as far as the Rec Center, we are celebrating National Water Safety Month, which is a great way to find the safety being around the pools and at night at the Romeoville Aquatic Center. The event will include safety water station tips and engage a hands-on activities for more about safety and being around the water, and there's no fee. This is actually free. And it will be registration required by May 22nd from 5 to 7. And then Opportunity Matters will be hosting a leadership style workshop May 22nd from 6 to 7 at the Village Athletic Center. And our guest speaker will be Sean Tay, King of Romeoville. And then also the Golden Agers. Keep this in mind for some of you people that are up there that I know that you like the other game, bingo, but this is the Bunko night, Wednesday, May 8th, cost $5 at Romeoville Center Gymnasium. And that's what I have. Thank you.
Very good. Trustee Griffin, Veterans Commission.
Thank you, Mayor. I want to invite everyone to join us on Monday, May the 27th at 10 o'clock in the morning for Romeoville's annual Memorial Day service. And it'll take place at the Doc McCartan Veterans Memorial at 11 Montrose Drive. And that's all I have.
Very good. Trustee Palmetto, Finance Special Events for Royal Lake Humane Society.
Thank you, Mayor. Just briefly, the next Special Events Commission meeting is Tuesday, July 16th at 4:30 p.m. at the Rec Center. Next finance meeting will be May 8th at 4 p.m. here at Village Hall. And that's it. Thank you.
Very good. Village Manager's Report.
Thank you, Your Honor. Just a few quick updates. You mentioned the plane pull. Again, thank you to police and Public Works for participating in that. The fire department also did a fundraiser with CITGO for MDA. So the departments are doing really good stuff out in the community. So thank them for that. Public Works open house is May 18th from 9 to noon. So I want to make sure the public has information on that. We talked a lot about a lot of construction projects that are going to be coming up over the summer. Just a reminder to the public, all of these will be on our website. We'll have a map of the projects on there, information of approximate dates when that's going to happen and where they can find more information, not only on our projects, but our construction projects within the community. Some of the development ones that Trustee Richards was talking about, some of those newer ones will be on there as well. And then finally, we have fire and police training over at the REMA facility, May 7th through the 9th. So you know, the community may see some activity over there, but it is training and it will be within the fenced in area for the most part. So I'm sure we'll get some calls on that. And then the last thing is just for the board's information. We've spent a lot of time on the Lake Michigan Water Project. We're getting to the final phase of the formation. So we will have an update for the board and final agreements that the board will have to approve on the June 26th meeting.
Very good. New business.
Move for consent agenda.
Second.
Motion for a consent agenda for new business as by Trustee Griffin. Motion second by Trustee Geary. Any further discussion? Give me a roll call if you could, please.
Trustee Griffin.
Aye.
Trustee Geary.
Aye.
Trustee Palmeyer.
Aye.
Trustee Clancy.
Aye.
And Trustee Richards.
Aye.
Motion carried.
Very good. Then within that consent agenda, then for new business, we have ordinance 24-19-14, ordinance adopting amendments to chapter 42A and chapter 151 of the Village Code of Ordinances. Resolution 24-37-80, resolution to waive the bid process and enter into a professional service contract with Applied Research Associates to perform pavement condition surveys. Resolution 24-37-84, resolution to approve a task order for Strand Engineering for the planning and design services for the lake water supply modifications. Resolution 24-37-85, resolution to waive the bid process and accept the lowest proposal and enter into a contract for the 2024 hot mix asphalt program. Resolution 24-37-86, resolution to approve the extension of the concrete repair program with Builders Concrete. Resolution 24-37-87, a resolution to waive the bid process and accept the lowest proposal and enter into a contract for the 2024 subdivision resurfacing project. Resolution 24-37-88, resolution to approve the amendment to the professional service agreement for proposal for Hitchcock Design Group for Romeo Crossing Phase 3. Resolution 24-37-89, a resolution authorizing an agreement with Live Barn, Inc.
So moved.
Second.
Motion approved by Trustee Griffin, enthusiastically seconded by Trustee Palmeyer. any further discussion? Hearing none, can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Griffin.
Aye.
Trustee Palmeyer.
Aye.
Trustee Clancy.
Aye.
Trustee Richards.
Aye.
Trustee Geary.
Aye.
Motion carried.
Very good. Board comments. Trustee Palmeyer, please.
Thank you, Mayor. First of all, I'd like to recognize that Ovation Center is open and just a great project. It's worthwhile stepping foot in there and see what's offered. It's just going to be a great asset, I think, to the village. Maddie, great project. And sadly, that is now and continues to be an issue for female students, females in general. And it's people like her that will make a difference eventually. Great project. Thanks to Mike for his update on the retail grocery. It's good to let our residents know how hard our staff and he have been working for daily. And it is what it is, and until things change, there's not a lot we can do, but we will continue to pursue it like we have in the past. Thanks to Kelly and staff for the Aquatic Center and all the work that was taken to get there. And I think it's running well, and I think it's going to continue to be a great asset, too. That's all I think I have, because I've scribbled so much I can't read my writing anymore.
That's okay. Trustee Griffin, please.
Thank you, Mayor. I also want to say about the grocery study. We hear you. We've seen your posts on Facebook. We totally understand, and we are working very hard to try and make that happen. But as like everybody says, we've never said no. Water Safety Month, it's important now. Kids in the neighborhood, there are swimming pools, there are water, detention ponds and things in the area. If you don't know how to swim, go to the Aquatic Center to learn how to swim, no matter how old you are. If you're a little kid, it's real important. If you're an adult, you need to know how to swim to save a little kid, maybe. So take advantage of those programs. They're available to you. Mental health, real important. The village now has mental health experts that are available to assist you. If you do, or a family member has an issue with mental health, please contact us. And all moms and grandmas out there, happy Mother's Day. And that's all I've got.
Very good. Tristan, please.
Thank you. Congratulations to the Gold Award winners from the Girl Scouts. And don't forget the Golden Agers Bunko Night. That's Wednesday, May 8th from 6 p.m. to 9 p.m. And to all the mothers, since Ken mentioned it once, I got it on my notes here. To all the mothers, happy Mother's Day coming up. And if you'll sort of put up with this comment, this is sort of a personal comment, but happy birthday to the wife coming up in a few more days. Happy birthday, Linda. And that'd be it. Thank you.
Very good. Trustee Richards, please.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Just a couple of quick things. First off, obviously, congratulations to Maddie Cernick on your gold status with the Girl Scouts. Yeah, an amazing young lady. She'll go far. She'll do a lot in this world. What a phenomenal project she worked on. Proud to have her as a resident of the village of Romeoville. I just want to make a brief comment on the rec center. We talked about, you know, everything going on, Water Safety Month, and with the new aquatic center open. The calendar of events for summer is out. So starting June 1st, I guess they're going to be a little busy. 28 events I counted on the calendar this summer.
Just a couple.
I think there's a few that might be missing, quite honestly. Or I just read through it too quickly. So, you know, you see Kelly and any of her staff out at these events, thank them for all they do. These events are, for the most part, free to the residents, free to the area. You get to come out, have a good time, enjoy some fellowship, meet some people. Whether it's a concert, whether it's a park party, whatever the case may be, there's just so much to do in this community, and I can't thank the rec staff enough for everything they put into making that happen for us. Thank you.
Very good. Trustee Geary, please.
Thank you, Mayor. I also want to thank Maddie Cernick for her gold status with the Girl Scouts and her wonderful effort for awareness for female athletes in the arts and everything else where we sometimes tend to get overlooked or overlook people. So that's great. We just have to keep it on the forefront. Thanks to the gentleman for the grocery update, because, you know, as we say, either Facebook or my clients at the salon are always asking about that. And we just tell them they're moving parts and they're always looking to bring that to us. And happy Mother's Day to all the moms. That's all I have.
Very good. Executive session? We're no announcement, though. No announcement. Very good. I'll entertain a motion to go to executive session.
So moved.
Second.
Give that one to Trustee Clancy. Second, Trustee Aguirre.
Okay.
Any further discussion? All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Nays. The ayes have it. We're going to executive session.